Now we're going to look at calculating the output speed of various gear trains. So we were talking about a 8-tooth gear driving a 40-tooth gear, which we saw here. And how do we actually go about calculating what that ratio is going to be? Well, we can actually just do this sort of comparison showing that 8 compared to the 40. And if we reduce that down, that comes out to be a 1-to-5 relationship, which means the 40 will turn one time for the 8 turning 5 times. And so we can watch that here. If I turn the 8-tooth gear, the smaller one, 5 times, we'll watch how fast the blue one goes. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, and the blue one, the 40-tooth gear, rotated one full time. Similarly, we looked at the 40-tooth gear compared to the 20-tooth. I can do the same relationship, and 40 over 20 comes out to a 2-to-1, which means that the 20-tooth will move twice for every one rotation of the 40. And here I have that depicted. If I turn the 40-tooth gear one full rotation, you can see that the 20-tooth gear, the smaller one, goes around twice. So what happens when we actually have a much larger gear train than just two together? For instance, what happens if I have a 24-tooth gear connected up to a 40-tooth gear, finally connected up to a small 8-tooth gear? What we can do is we can break this into parts. So if we look at this first relationship, this is going to be a 24-to-40, which reduces down to a 3-to-5 relationship. And then for the second half, we have a 40-to-8, which is a 5-to-1, similar to what we saw up there. What you can do is actually multiply these together. So if we do a 3-to-5 times the 5-to-1, that actually, the 5s cancel out, and we have a 3-to-1 relationship saying that the 8-tooth gear will turn 3 times for one rotation of the 24-tooth gear. I actually have that built right here, this gear train. So we have a 24 on one side, 40 in the middle, and a small 8-tooth gear here on the edge. And so what I will do is I will turn the orange one, the 24-tooth, one full rotation, and we'll count to see how many times the 8 turns, the 8-tooth gear turns. So as we go around, we have 1, 2, and 3 rotations, showing that there is this 3-to-1 relationship between the 24 and the 8. So to show that again, we started with the 24-to-40, and we combine that together with a 40-to-8, and the two 40s cancel out, resulting in a 24-to-8 or a 3-to-1 sort of relationship. What this indicates, though, is that that middle gear actually doesn't matter. So if we had a large gear train, so if we had our 24 here at the beginning, no matter what other gears, what other sizes we put in the middle, and I'll just give them variable names here to represent that, if it comes out to the last value, we could do out this math. So this first one is a 24 to W times a W to X times an X to Y times a Y to Z times a Z to 8. What does that equal? After all the cancellations, 24 to 8 or a 3-to-1, just like we saw here in this example. If the beginning and the last gear are the exact same size, then what you have is a 1-to-1. But what you'll notice here is that these two are actually rotating in opposite directions. And that has to do with the number of gears that we have in line here. So if there's an even number of gears, then what you find is that the two first and last gears turn in opposite directions. And if you have an odd number, they will turn in the same direction.